In this video, we are going to solve problems on normal stress and tangential stress. So here are the list of formulae. The first formula corresponds to your normal stress, that if you are having any inclined plane, you can find normal stress on that inclined plane using this formula. The sign convention for putting values of stresses, tensile stress as a positive, and if the stress is compressive stress, means the arrow is towards the body, then I am going to use a negative sign. The third one is theta value. Here we always measure the theta value from vertical axis. So let's start our first problem, and the statement is, the principal stresses at a point in a section of a boiler shell are 120 MPa and 30 MPa, both are tensile. Find normal stress, tangential stress and resultant stress across plane through the point inclined at 50 degree to plane carrying 120 MPa stress. So here first we write down the given data, that is tensile stress sigma x is 120 Newton per mm square. And tensile stress sigma y is 30 Newton per mm square. And we have to calculate normal stress, tangential stress and resultant stress on inclined plane. So for the normal stress, that is sigma n, here we have the values of tensile stress sigma x and sigma y, and the plane inclined at an angle 50 degree with vertical axis, that is theta is 50 degree. So put these values in formula, and here I will get normal stress will be 67.18 Newton per mm square. And here the normal stress is positive, that means it is away from the body. Now let's try to find out shear stress, that is tangential stress on inclined plane. So I will put the values of sigma x and sigma y in this formula, and I will get tangential stress on inclined plane, that will be 44.31 Newton per mm square. Now to calculate resultant stress on inclined plane, we have the values of normal stress and tangential stress. So put these values of sigma n and tau theta in formula, and I'll calculate resultant stress on inclined plane, that will be 80.47 Newton per mm square, which is tensile. Now for the next problem, the statement is, at a point in a strain material, tensile stress sigma x is 40 MPa acting along x direction, and tensile stress sigma y is acting along y direction. If tangential stress developed on plane is 8.66 MPa, which is making angle of 30 degree to y direction, calculate tensile stress sigma y and normal stress. So here we have the tensile stress sigma x is 40 Newton per mm square, and tangential stress on 30 degree inclined plane is 8.66 Newton per mm square, and we need to calculate tensile stress, that is sigma y. So here in this formula for tangential stress, that is tau theta, so put the values of sigma x and I will get tensile stress, that is sigma y, will be 20 Newton per mm square. And here the formula for normal stress on inclined plane. So put the values of sigma x and sigma y, and we'll get normal stress on inclined plane, that will be 35 Newton per mm square, which is tensile. Now for the next problem, the statement is, at a point in a strain material subjected to two mutually perpendicular stresses of 200 MPa compressive and 350 MPa tensile, determine intensities of normal stress and tangential stress on a plane inclined at 38 degree to plane carrying stress 200 MPa. So first we'll write down the given data, that is sigma x is minus 200 Newton per mm square, where negative sign indicates compressive stress. And sigma y is 350 Newton per mm square, which is tensile stress. So to calculate normal stress on inclined plane, I will take theta value as 38 degree and put the values of sigma x and sigma y, and I will get normal stress on inclined plane, that will be 8.47 Newton per mm square. A tangential stress will calculate minus 266.75 Newton per mm square. Now for the next problem, the statement is, at a point in cross section of a loaded beam where major principal stress is 70 MPa and maximum shear stress is 40 MPa, find minor principal stress and direct stress on plane of maximum shear stress. Here in the problem, we have the values of major principal stress is 70 Newton per mm square and maximum shear stress is 40 Newton per mm square. And to calculate normal stress, I will put these values in maximum shear stress formula, and minor principal stress we got as minus 10 Newton per mm square, which is compressive. And the formula for direct stress on a plane of maximum shear stress is sigma n1 plus sigma n2 divided by 2. So put these values and I will calculate direct stress on a plane of maximum shear stress will be 30 Newton per mm square. For the next problem, the statement is, the principal stresses at a point in a section of member are 100 Newton per meter square and 50 Newton per meter square. Both are tensile. Find normal stress and tangential stress across plane passing through that point inclined at 60 degree to plane having stress 100 Newton per meter square. Also calculate resultant stress, angle of obliquity, maximum shear stress and normal stress on maximum shear. So here values of sigma x and sigma y is given in the problem, and we have to calculate normal and tangential stresses on 60 degree inclined plane. That means theta value is 60 degree. So put the values in formula and I will get normal stress as 62.5 Newton per meter square, and tangential stress will calculate as 21.65 Newton per meter square. And to calculate resultant stress, that is sigma r, is under root sigma n square plus tau theta square. So put the values and I'll calculate resultant stress, that will be 66.14 Newton per meter square, and angle of obliquity, that is phi. So I will get angle of obliquity as 19.1 degree. Now the maximum shear stress is sigma x minus sigma y by 2. So put the values of sigma x and sigma y and I'll calculate maximum shear stress as plus 25 Newton per meter square and minus 25 Newton per meter square. And the planes of maximum shear are inclined at 45 degree to principal planes. So the normal stress sigma n is sigma x plus sigma y by 2. So the normal stress on plane of maximum shear, that will be 75 Newton per meter square.